I don't watch Dancing with the Stars. I know Marlo's mom, our intern, likes to tape it on VHS. I know Midas's mom watches it with him before they go out for wings at Puck and Wings. I don't know. Well, Derek, I know you don't watch really anything.
No.
But you don't even have cable.
Yeah, but we got a lot of channels. I finally figured out I had to turn my antenna southeast to get all the Buffalo channels. Now I get everything.
Oh, do you really?
Good.
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
Anyway, so you don't watch it, obviously.
Yeah, it's weird. I watched the whole show last night, and there's just nothing else on. We're just sort of...
Dude, the Duke game was on. The Butler, the NCAA final.
It wasn't even really on yet. Like, this was on from 8 till 9:30-ish, I think, or something.
Oh. UConn. Butler lost for the second year in a row.
I watched Canada Spells. Spelling Night in Canada on CBC.
Yeah, I saw that.
They had a big spelling bee on the CBC last night.
Oh, did they?
Yeah. Hosted by Houston.
Who's Houston?
Jim Houston.
No idea. Jim Houston.
The guy that does
the hockey.
Oh, the sports guy. Yeah. Okay, yeah.
Anyways, continue on with your...
Well, what I'm saying was that we don't normally watch this, but you watched it last night, Todd, and made us aware of an incident Kirstie Alley had with her dance partner, Max. This guy, he's apparently the best male dancer. Like, he wins most of the competitions with his partners, I guess.
Okay, that I didn't know.
So he's been saddled with this 60-year-old fat chick named Kirstie Alley. Now, last night, it all came to a head.
Oh, yes, it did.
So I don't have the actual audio of the wipeout.
I have. It might not be good because it's someone taping his TV. That's what
fine.
I have.
Okay. That's fine.
So here we go. Are we on mute? You got to...
No, he doesn't.
Kirstie.
It's just starting now. Sort of little move here. And she's leaning on him a bit. Little pressure and... Oh!
Do they get up and keep going?
He sort of has to pause for a few seconds.
Oh, because he's injured. Her fat has injured him.
Yeah.
Kirstie Alley's fat injured the dancer.
Yeah, that's...
So during the post game on Access Hollywood, the post show interviews, here's some lady interviewing Max and Kirstie Alley over the incident.
It's... Oh my God! I was in the audience and I said no. No, first
we're doing aerials. Look, we wanted to try something different. We wanted to do aerials.
No, let me tell you, I at first was wondering, was it part of the dance?
I did too.
We were kissing last week, and this week we decided to go. No.
Oh, seriously, Max, what happened?
Just a muscle contusion. It's like a Charlie horse.
Uh-huh. You know how hard it is to get a Charlie horse?
It's a Kirstie horse.
Do you know how hard it is to get a Charlie horse from fat?
Yeah.
Listen, this is the guy from Dancing with the Stars. Talking about how Kirstie Alley leaned on his leg gave due to her sheer fat, and this is the injury he suffered as a result.
Kissing last week, and this week we decided to go. No.
Oh, seriously, Max, what happened?
Just a muscle contusion. It's like a Charlie horse.
Listen to the rest, though. This is great.
And it's straining.
Is it that your leg just simply gives out?
Just give up, yeah. It never happens again. It's just a little bruised, but I'll be fine.
I can't.
Wow. You know what he wants to say, right? You know what he wants to say.
Yeah, that pig weighs a lot.
Yeah. When I got into dancing, I never imagined a 300-pound thigh breaking my thigh, basically.
Listen, you got to listen to how they just a lot of strain, he says. Listen.
And it's straining.
Is it that your leg just simply gives out?
Just give up, yeah. Never happened to me, and never happens again.
That's got to make her feel good, too.
Never happened to me, never happened.